ChatGPT, Gemini, DeepSeek, all of these artificial intelligence have taken over the world in the last 5 years. But forget all that. Forget everything you know about AI. Because here at QualiaZ, we want to feed your curiosity with knowledge made simple. I am here to make sure you get the fullest understanding of the hottest topic right now. And today, we're going to show you a completely different world of AI. In fact, this will make you question intelligence as a whole. According to textbook definition, AI is the use or study of computer system or machines that have some qualities that the human brain has, such as the ability to interpret and produce language in a way that seems human, recognize or create images, solve problems, and learn from data supplied to them. But that is such a simple definition of AI. It doesn't tell you the full picture. To really understand things, you have to look at something called a control system. A control system is just something that manages the device condition or status based on your input.
But let's see what the experts think.
And today, a control system, everybody has experience with it. For example, if you take a plane, then when the pilot turns, and I call AI, a control system, make sure that you feel comfortable. It's actually very complicated. Only a machine can do that. And more recent example is drones, involving 10,000 drones, and they all go into place at a certain time, and they do a lot of things. And all of these drones have these control systems inside, and the whole thing is controlled. So to say that AI is just ChatGPT, that may be what are the big tech giants today want to believe, but actually it's been there a long time.
Imagine leaving your window open on a summer day and it's 29 degrees, or in freedom unit, 84. So you turn on the AC and set it to 24. The aircon realizes that it's only 29, so it spends power to cool it down. But let's say that it rained last night and the weather isn't as hot, it's only 25 outside. The same thing would happen, but dropping down by 1 degree would require less power. So whatever happens, your room will stay 24 degrees. Control system allow daily appliances and systems like the AC to function with barely any errors to make our lives better. But what if the task is more complicated? One of which is how you fly a plane. Flying a plane from New York to Tokyo is simple. All you have to do is keep track of speed, altitude, direction, fuel level, engine, temperature, communication, adapt to the weather, navigation, and so on. And to do all that for 10 hours and more, all that balancing and adjustment during a flight creates a miserable experience for pilots. And AI stayed this way for years, trained to do specific stuff like playing chess or farming. All for the sake of improving our lives. But we crave for something more, something that we can actually relate to, something we can talk with, something human-like.
See, previous iterations, they were very narrow, you know, chess playing, Go playing, they're great capabilities, but very narrow, and they really didn't influence people's lives. The thing is that humans fundamentally communicate. Communication and the transmission of knowledge across generations is really what makes us intelligent. And the ChatGPT moment is really about the very first time we could communicate quite naturally with a computer. So it's the illustration of communication that can get people. Previously, you know, chess playing impressed some chess players, that's all. But communication, now so many people can do it.
However amazing at conversation it may be, we can't ask ChatGPT to fly a plane, because we already have autopilot to do so. And the same goes for the other way around. We can't ask a plane's autopilot to help us generate a list of happy birthday gifts. That is the limitation of what we would call today artificial narrow intelligence. It describes all the AI that we have. It can only do a limited number of tasks it's designed to do, and it really cannot learn to do more than that. But we want it to do more, to learn to do things outside of what it's intended to do, and help us in our lives.
And that is what people would call artificial general intelligence.
Looking on OpenAI's website, the biggest company doing research in AI right now, you can see that their mission is to ensure that artificial general intelligence benefits all of humanity. You can see AGI as a much stronger version of AI than we have right now, where it can adapt across different tasks, do multiple things, and it can bring in general world knowledge to refine and to help it learn even further. Just like we do as humans, the goal we have for this technology is to create a safe and powerful AI that can help us innovate, help us progress, and head to the future faster.
Now, this technology is currently unobtainable, but we do have some sort of ideas of what it looked like based on fiction, based on things like Jarvis from Iron Man, for example. But in reality, what does it look like?
Think of translation, you know, translating Vietnamese to English. I use Translator a lot. It's pretty good. But the current translators are trained a sentence at a time. Real conversations have multiple sentences, and they bring information from multiple sentences. And they also use world knowledge. So to get the last bit of improvement in translation, you can't have this narrow system that's just trained to do translation on translation data. You need to bring in the world knowledge, bring in the reasoning, so that you can carry information across from three sentences ago. You can fill in the details about objects because you know about them. You know what different, you know what a cat is, for instance. So bringing in that experience of the world lets you complete whatever task you're doing.
However, is that really the way we want to move forward with this? To put all computational power into one entity? I mean, is that really all there is to intelligence?
We think of it as a single individual who has so much brain power, oh my God, okay? And that's what this discussion about general artificial intelligence, they're trying to get there. Yes. And I'm saying, you're missing 99.9% of what intelligence might be. Just look at the forest. It's a network. It's more like a social network. It's more collective intelligence. It's more networked intelligence. And so our discussion misses completely the point, I think. And we should look at nature. We should look at what happens in nature. And we should be a lot more humble.
Look at nature. Trees don't have brain like us, but they still have their own type of intelligence and they can still talk to each other. In a tree network, they have a fungal system in their roots. And through that system, they can talk to each other, warn each other about threats like insects or talk about the weather. If we look at intelligence through different mediums like nature, for example, we can learn how Mother Nature did it because, well, nature has been around for decades, for centuries, for millennia. They have their own way of working things out. Maybe we can learn a thing or two, and it's worth exploring.
What if we take this new viewpoint of intelligence and redefine what it means to have artificial intelligence in our lives? In our upcoming series, we will discuss how AI is impacting humanity in various fields like art, science, healthcare, and more. But most importantly, we will try to answer the biggest question there is: will AI live among humans in the future? Catch you next time.